Hello there, my name is Leonard Paul, and I wanted to show you how I put together the music for SimCell, as well as the sound design. But first, I'll show you the music. So here's my Generative Music Synthesizer. It's made in a programming language called Pure Data, which I've been using for a long time now. And it's just a great way for me to quickly put stuff together for music and also for visuals as well. And the neat thing is that it's open source. You can download it for free. I'll put a link at the end of the video. And you can also download a lot of these components as well. So I'll also show you what the links are for those too. So the video game SimCell is put out by Strange Loop Games, and it's an educational game meant to teach high school students about the human cell. And so what I wanted to do with the music is to really have it so that people would be drawn into sort of like what life is. And so I thought that the best way of doing that is to really make the music literally come alive as well. So I was really inspired by the work of Brian Eno on the video game Spore, and they use Pure Data a little bit as well there, and they use generative techniques to generate the music. So generative music basically just means that the notes are being generated as the music is playing. So it's kind of like the computer is composing it in real time. So that's what is happening here. And what I'll do is go through all the details of how that's done. One of the cool things about Pure Data is that it not only does audio, but it also does graphics as well. So what I've done is put together a small visualizer to show when the instruments are being triggered. Here's instrument 1, 2, 3, and 4, which are from over here, and then there's the granulation layer from the middle. And then when there's a square behind it, that means that that particular instrument is being triggered. The overall mix is set by the mix sequencer, which really just mutes and unmutes instruments to give a shape to the piece. So instruments are brought in and out over time from left to right there. And so these are the instruments. These are where the notes for the instruments come from. And then notes are also sent to the granulation engine down here that has two comb filters attached to it. And then the mix is on the right hand side. So if we look at when this encounters, the mix sequencer encounters a scene change here, we can see that another instrument will be brought in. See? There we go. So one of the neat things about it being all based in generative notes is that I can change the BPM, like the tempo, dynamically. So I can ramp it up. Right, or ramp it down, and you can hear the comb filters also being stretched there, and then I can put it back to the default. Alright, so as far as how the instruments are being generated, they're just being generated in here. So if we look in here, there are just blips. And this particular instrument is made by Martin Brinkmann. I'll send you a link as far as where you can get this stuff from. He has a whole bunch of great instruments for PD available for free. And if you look at it, you can see that, yeah, basically it's just a sine wave. And it's using the poly, so it's a polyphonic instrument. And it can handle up to 16 different notes. So as far as how the granulation works in this, I'm using a patch by Martin Brinkmann, and I've modified it so that you can derive the grain, like the grain sample data, from different grain sources. So it just allows you to use different tables, and so that way I can sort of do a granular crossfade between two different samples. So the way that the music changes with response to the game, the different gameplay sort of possibilities, through scenes. So here, I can make it sound like you're being attacked by a virus. Right? So we changed to the reverb violin sound, and it's all scary. Right? And it also changes the notes as well. Right? And then I can go back again to the original scene. So you can see that it's a smooth transition. All right, so this sort of purple back chunk in the middle here is where the notes get sequenced, and I can change the way that the patches are changed here from the scene changes. So if I look at different, you know, these are the different layers that go out here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? All the notes there. So this one here would go out to instrument number 1. All right, so let's have a look at how the visualizer is working with the different notes. Instrument 1 is that lead line. This is the granulation layer. And these consistent, a lot of these are made by the comb filters. You could download all of these components on your own and then make your own generative music synthesizer. So I used a lot of patches from Martin Brinkmann, and then also RjDj is a great source of Pure Data patches as well. And of course you can download Pure Data from puredata.info, and I'll give you the links for everything that you need at the end of the video. Alright, so if I basically go to the visualizer here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I mute stuff out, we can see that instruments 2 to 4 get muted out here. See? Now I've just got instrument number 1. So that sort of drone-y stuff there is basically all the granulation that's happening. And you can hear the comb filters change. All right, well, hopefully you've enjoyed the presentation, and it gives you a good sort of introduction and idea how generative music really works in a video game or just in general. So, yeah, if you're interested in asking me any questions about my patch, then just go to videogameaudio.com, and my email is on there. So I look forward to hearing from you. All right, so switching over to the sound design for SimCell, this is an overview of the patch that is used to generate all the sound design, right? All sorts of great stuff there to do with cells. And every single sound has an intensity slider that goes from 0 to 1, from low intensity all the way up to high intensity. So on this one, the high is 1, so it makes the gate open slower, right? And then intensity 0, faster. Okay, and if we look inside the patch, we can see that basically it's just a noise waveform that gets sort of sampled and held. So in other words, I'm changing like the sampling rate basically, and it goes through a filter here. And the envelope of the filter changes over time. And then I turn this patch off when it's no longer being used to save on CPU. So over here, these are the interface sounds, and I used a 303 to simulate those. So, all right, so I'm just changing patch values, and that's all that's going on. Rollover. So yeah, and that's what it looks like on the inside. It's all the patch changes and stuff. All right, let's have a look at some sounds from over here. So these are some shooting sounds. Oh yeah, that's cool. And my favorite one, which is the stuck cat sound. Oh, poor kitty. All right, so if we pan down here, we can see where the engine sound is made. So here it is, low intensity. High intensity, off, and then inside the patch, here it is, and as you can see, it's basically just filtered noise. Okay, and that's it. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video explaining the audio for SimCell, and if you want to get a hold of me, I'm at videogameaudio.com. Make sure to check out all the links at the end of the video, and yeah, thanks for watching.